The world is changing. In fact, it already has. We've heard it so many times. So many generations have been sure they're experiencing real change. The dynamics are the same in the automotive world too. The issues the first motorists had were very different from those experienced by drivers today.
C'era poesia e stile nella febbre meccanica di fine 800. Hai una piccola panna. I capricci delle prime automobili si chiamavano così, pan, e conferivano ai viaggi un delizioso sapore di avventura, purché non durassero troppo, ben inteso.
Ci vuole molto?
No, solo un momentino.
Durò 2 ore quel momentino.
Advertising was different from the form we're familiar with now. We used to ask, what's the difference between leaded and unleaded petrol? The questions we now ask have changed, as has the way we look for the answers. This is a digital, virtual and electric era.
La 500 viene realizzata anche nella versione a trazione elettrica, una tappa importante. È la prima volta che un costruttore presenta un nuovo modello in prima mondiale anche con propulsione elettrica. La 500 Electra ha un cambio a 5 marce ed è alimentata da 12 batterie. La ricarica, con l'alimentazione domestica, è di 8 ore.
Surprised? Back in 1991, an electric 500 was already on the market, although a profoundly different one from today's. The constant quest for products with lower CO2 emissions now features hybrid and electric models. Indeed, FCA's electrification strategy is coming to market right now. Finally, the future is here. Let's clear things up a little by answering a few frequently asked questions. What is a hybrid car? Hybrid cars use electricity as the energy source for an auxiliary motor to complement the internal combustion engine running on petrol or diesel. There are several types of hybrids. Mild hybrids, with an electric motor that doesn't propel the wheels but helps the conventional engine to work more efficiently. Examples include the Panda, the 500 and the Ypsilon, all sharing the name hybrid. Then come full hybrids and plug-in hybrids, equipped with a conventional internal combustion engine and batteries that can be charged directly from a power outlet, meaning the car can run dozens of kilometers on the electric motor alone. The Jeep, Compass and Renegade 4xe are the perfect examples of plug-in hybrid cars. A technology capable of positively impacting even Jeep's legendary off-road capabilities, courtesy of the higher torque provided by the electric motor. Now it's time to look at electric cars. How do they work? The electric motor uses the energy supplied by the battery, converting it to the mechanical energy needed to propel the car. The electrical energy stored in the battery is transferred to the electric motor by an inverter. This device converts the direct current DC from the reservoir to alternating current AC and transmits it to the motor. When the accelerator is released or when braking, the electric motor acts as a generator and charges the battery. The new Fiat 500 works the same way too, guaranteeing a carefree drive with great performance and a range of hundreds of kilometers. How are electric cars developed? New challenges must be faced when developing an electric car. As well as reliability of the components, there are new aspects to focus on. For example, the durability and effectiveness of the batteries, tested in extreme conditions to ensure optimum resistance in any situation. There's also the acoustics, not the sound of the motor and engine, instead how noise-free the passenger compartment is and the acoustic safety alerts. Just as essential are crash tests, where new electric car components, including the electric motor and battery pack, are required to demonstrate optimum resilience. Do electric cars require much maintenance? Conventional engines consist of hundreds of components. If these are not assembled perfectly and maintained in the best possible conditions, they can fail over time. An electric motor has far fewer components. Logically, this equates to a lower risk of mishaps and breakdowns, meaning electric cars need less frequent maintenance while remaining highly reliable, even in the long term. How is an electric car charged? Electric cars can be charged from a variety of sockets, for use at home, such as FCA's Easy Wall Box, or for public charging, like the fast charge points available around the country. The time it takes to fully charge the car depends on the output the source can deliver, which goes from 2.2 to over 100 kilowatts on DC or AC. What is the range of an electric car? The numbers of kilometers an electric car can travel depends on the energy storage capacity of the batteries and the way the car is used. For example, the new Fiat 500 has a range of up to 320 kilometers in the combined cycle, even more in the urban cycle. But new models alone are not enough. Through its e-mobility division, FCA is therefore designing a true ecosystem of support services for hybrid and electric cars. It includes the plants where our hybrid and electric cars are built, as well as FCA dealerships across Europe, with their total of 3,600 charge points already present or waiting to be installed. There's also our agreements with various partners, whereby the power grid will be able to deal with new demand for electricity, partly using vehicle-to-grid infrastructure. Last but not least, 150,000 square meters of solar panels are due to be installed at the Mirafiori plant to produce 15 megawatts of power and contribute to reducing carbon dioxide emissions by over 5,000 tons. New steps towards electrification, steps whereby FCA can immediately measure up to the new challenges of offering more innovative, effective, and advantageous solutions for the planet, for cities, and for the customers of the future.